We usually seek to eliminate strokes in an engine to increase its power and reduce weight. But when it comes to saving fuel and fighting electric vehicles, perhaps the correct answer is to increase them. The 5-stroke engine is a powerful and efficient machine. It is made up of 3 cylinders and can rotate at 7,000 revolutions per minute, delivering 130 horsepower. All this from only 0.7 liters. Passing the tests on the dynamometer, today we'll be analyzing it and seeing how it works. This new 5-stroke engine was patented by a Belgian engineer named Gerhard Smith. Gerhard was based on a previous version developed by Daimler at the beginning of the century that did not work well at all. Since 1980, Gerhard worked tirelessly, until only in 2002 he obtained his patent for the machine. In 2007, Gerhard managed to convince and partner with Ilmor from England, a company that builds engines for IndyCar and Formula One. Using the skill of their engineers and advanced technological equipment, they finally got the first prototype, so let's see in detail how it works. The engine has a 3-cylinder flat plane crankshaft. From here, their respective connecting rods come out. Now we have 2 small pistons and a large central one. The small pistons are the high-pressure cylinders and the central one is the low-pressure cylinder. The size and weight of the central piston is equal to the sum of the 2 small pistons, so their masses are balanced in the same way as a 4-cylinder engine. The external high-pressure cylinders have the conventional 4 strokes: the intake stroke where the air enters the cylinder, compression where in this case its pressure is increased 7 times, combustion where due to burning of fuel the pressure increases more than 5 times and drives the piston down forcefully, and finally exhaust. Since it takes 2 revolutions of the crankshaft to complete the cycle, the cylinders fire first one and then the other. Now the different things begin. The center cylinder is double the size. When the exhaust stroke of a small cylinder begins, instead of directing the gases towards the atmosphere and wasting them, it turns out that these gases still have at least 5 times more pressure than when they entered the cylinder. Therefore, they are sent to the central cylinder to finish expanding, reducing their pressure by half and providing extra power. Now the piston rises and ends up discarding the gases. Then, the piston on the other side is now right in the exhaust stroke, so it feeds the central piston. As can be seen, everything is perfectly synchronized so that the central piston receives the gases from each cylinder at its appropriate time. There's a 3rd camshaft that drives the valves of this center cylinder and rotates at twice the speed of the normal camshaft. In summary, all the system makes an engine of 2-cylinder and 700cc of total displacement. With the help of the central expansion cylinder of 778cc, it can deliver 122 pound-feet of torque and 130 horsepower at 7,000 RPM. All this with 30% less fuel consumption than an engine of the same power. Optionally, a water injector can be installed to take advantage of the heat of these gases. When water is injected, it immediately transforms into steam, expanding and increasing the pressure, providing more power. Although, as a con, a new tank should be added to store water. In addition, since the water is going to evaporate, it must be demineralized or else it will fill the piston with deposits. This water has a monetary cost close to fuel that should not be ignored. However, if the water runs out, the operation of the engine would not be affected. You'll just lose some power. It must also be considered that the water does not contaminate. In addition, a small turbo was installed on this engine to now take advantage of the exhaust gases for the 3rd time and introduce more air into the cylinder, raising the power even more. In summary, in this 5-stroke engine, with its 2 combustion cycles, it ends up having an expansion ratio of 1 to 14, while in a normal engine, it's 1 to 10. Being the year 2009, the engine was installed in a motorcycle to carry out field tests with very good results. But suddenly, the project was stopped since a famous German car firm hired Gerhard Schmidt. Ilmor, not having the patent, had no choice but to stop its research. However, the 5-stroke engine does not die here. Years later, Gerhard decided to continue with the engine again and worked with some French scientists. Together, they built a new prototype with offset cylinders. The central cylinder can deliver power more comfortably by improving the angle of the connecting rod, and the ports between the high and low pressure cylinders were made shorter with very good results. This engine was built to spin at fixed revolutions and power a generator as a range extender and charge batteries. Also, one of the valves now serves as a wastegate by regulating its opening. Finally, at the Polish Science University, a Volkswagen EA113 engine, also known by the 2.0 FSI that equipped the GTI Mark V, was selected, and the two central cylinders were unified by making a cut in the cylinder head. The valve openings were modified, and the four-cylinder engine was converted to five strokes. The two external cylinders work as usual. The two central cylinders now behave as if they were one cylinder twice in size. The exhaust gases pass through the middle passage and drive both pistons downward. They behave in the same way as a single large piston. On this opportunity, the university verified the following results. Advantages: any current engine can be converted to five strokes easily. It does not require special manufacturing systems and shares many parts. Increases fuel efficiency. Lowers the exhaust temperature as there is a second expansion cycle. Water injection can be used. Disadvantages: it has a greater number of moving parts. The exhaust gases have a lower temperature and are less effective with the catalyst to purify gases. By having less pressure, the turbo receives the gases at a lower speed, increasing turbo lag. With more moving parts, there's more friction. Fuel savings only occur effectively when the engine operates at maximum power. Otherwise, the exhaust gases will be too low and will not be enough to push the large piston. So at low load, there are simply no advantages. In fact, the extra parts increase losses, decreasing fuel economy. Simply put, it's only good for powering a generator as a range extender. There are other similar options with fewer parts, such as the Miller or Atkinson cycle that hybrid vehicles use today. Hit the like button if you made it this far in the video. Did you know this engine? Do you think it could come in the future? Leave your opinion in the comment box below. See you in the next video.